Welcome once again to Never Tell Me the Odds, the Star Wars RPG podcast, the podcast where a group of nerds, comedians, improvisers, and these guys.
Dandies.
The dandies, fine dandies, and roustabouts, gadflies, the whole hoi polloi are all here to play Never Tell Me the Odds, the Star Wars RPG by Fantasy Flight Games.
Yeah.
Welcome, guys. Welcome. Thanks for tuning in. We are broadcasting live from the Saving Throw Show studio in Hollywood, California.
Woo!
Yay!
That's so glamorous.
That's kind of cool. Hollyweed, right?
Oh, yes. Hollyweed. I'm sorry. It's good to be back in Hollyweed finally after being home for so long.
What? It's legal! We can stop pretending.
Only good news 2016.
Okay. Yeah. Isn't that next year?
No, it's legal now. We just can't buy it at stores until they approve a process for it, which
Weird.
They have until the 2018 deadline.
Yeah, they got some time.
2018?
I just think...
This is Starweed.
Welcome to Starweed. No, it's we're broadcasting live from Saving Throw, the place where it's GERD to be a nerd.
All right, we're going to take that one back to the drawing board.
That one first?
This is edited,
you plan
right?
That?
I'm not giving anybody that. I'm thinking that...
Gastrointestinal reflux disease.
I've been sitting on that one for a couple days.
All right, David's fired.
All right, well.
Does anybody else want to take over? Or?
So, yeah, guys, welcome. Welcome to everybody out there who's tuning in. As I always like to say, we're all adventurers. We've all been on a long journey. We've overcome many obstacles. But tonight, come in from the cold, grab yourselves a drink, and toast with us as we quaff. So, to everyone out there, hail adventurers!
Hail adventurers!
Let us drink.
I need it.
The best
can't.
Part about that is imagining David rehearsing it in front of a mirror. Like, it's adorable.
I'm a single man, baby. Yeah. This is all I
do. He's got his own Dodonna beard that he keeps putting on.
Yeah.
Then a fake mustache on top of the Dodonna beard.
Those are the happy moments between the tears. Like, it's pretty great.
Between the
Sometimes I do it while I'm crying. Oh, God. Welcome.
Hail adventurers. Like, yeah, that's pretty much my life at this point, right?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Well.
Yep. I'm strangely envious.
Yeah. When I was practicing that in front of the mirror, I thought it would be more fun.
It was fantastic.
It was great.
Keep going.
Yeah. We love
Thank
it.
Thank you. Guys, so did I welcome everyone yet? I think I did. Mm-hmm. Welcome to you guys at the table. I'm David Krennan. I am America's DM.
Woo woo.
Which makes you guys
America's players.
What? Yeah. High five for everyone.
Yes, sir.
Finger guns.
Don't leave people hanging. Come on. All right.
Sorry,
I need some skin.
And that's all the way around the table.
Changed. I was just conceptually confused by being America's players.
Yeah. We've spread whatever disease.
Oh, it's conceptually
Krennan has around the table.
It's a fake it till you make it type situation.
Mm-hmm. All right, America.
Hollywood indeed.
I'd like to apologize for all of the hate crimes.
Yeah, it's not as glamorous to be.
That are going
America.
To happen. It's
that you've been committing?
Pre-apologizing.
True.
What? No.
No hate crimes. Stop it. All right. So, I'm David Krennan.
Trainer,
as I
protected class.
Said, I'm sitting here with four amazing players, but I'm very excited to get into the game with tonight. Today I will start with Talene. Would you please introduce yourself and a little bit about your character?
Hey everybody, I'm Talene, and I'm playing Root Wriggles, everyone's favorite Ewok.
Root Rapid Wriggles?
Why are you looking at me?
Because I know she's not your favorite Ewok.
That's true.
That's why I keep saying
I got a new favorite now.
where did you meet other Ewoks?
Did you not watch the last show? There's another Ewok.
Oh, you're talking about Chibbit.
Chibbit.
I have none.
Chibbit.
Oh, boy.
Chibbit.
Competing Ewok.
I love you, Chibbit, if you're out there.
I can't compete with this other Ewok.
You would love him, too, though. He's great.
Yeah, he's pretty good. Well, but we all do love Root Wriggles. So Root Wriggles is an Ewok. Tell us a little bit about what motivates Miss
Wriggles. So Root Wriggles.
Miss Wriggles.
Root Wriggles was snatched from her planet and thought she died. So she thinks she's in the afterworld. And she's seeking a way to Nirvana.
Yep, that's about it. Do you think anyone is a god?
Oh, I think that androids.
Droids. Are,
droids are
commonly
gods.
Called.
Yes. Shh. I had a moment.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
Droids are gods, and people are food.
Mm-hmm. So. That sums you up, I think, in a nutshell. Yes, that's right.
I've actually been leaving her recipe books.
Yeah, you guys.
How to cook human?
I was gonna start with Toydarian, but sure.
Hey.
Yeah, you can.
Oh,
delicious.
Eat that tasty wing.
Yeah, we should really start with the one who's actually food.
You're half lobster.
So the other thing we should note about you is you've got an adorable pet. Is that right?
The cutest pet in the world.
How is that not dead yet?
Because I like it.
Oh, are we not dead yet?
That's a very... No, that's a
great question.
Yeah. No, he's a soft-hearted man.
It's because it's not narratively satifying to kill you before the final adventure, which it now is.
Oh, yeah.
Uh-oh.
Okay, so that's Root in a nutshell.
No, this is Root in a nutshell. Oh, help, I'm trapped in a nutshell.
Cutting over.
It's going to be that kind of a...
Live from the set of the Love Guru.
I like that one. I'm going to cut over to our gentleman on the left side, my left. Who are you playing, Drew, and who are you? Are you Drew?
I'm Drew. Hi, I'm going to be playing P9L, and he's one of them robots. He's a hired killing machine, and his most recent patron has gone now missing. And so he's a bit lost. He also suffers from a touch of robotic dysmorphia, and has committed his basic entire existence to gaining enough credits to upgrade his body continually until he reaches perfection, which we all know is impossible.
But you do have, and this is interesting, and even if you're a regular viewer, I might need to remind you of this. In our last adventure, episode 5, The Secret of Fabian's Roost.
Yes, sorry, I was very excited.
You got, you finally got a jetpack.
Yeah.
Old school jetpack.
In your butt.
Well, yeah, why not in your butt? There we go. Well, it's fused, it somehow got fused to you, so you do kind of have this like big, clunky, even for the Rocketeer style jetpack. Probably with little wings that stick out off the sides to make it hard for you to get through doorways. But it is a jetpack, which has been, a long...
Yes.
Okay. It's expensive to keep fueled.
Well, sure.
Okay. Yes.
That's why I keep stealing fuel from our refueling depot.
A lot of crashes right around your guys' casino. Let's go over to this side again.
Okay.
Who are
Hi.
I'm going to go to our guest last.
Okay.
Or the newest face last, right? Okay, so Garav, who are you, and are you Garav?
Hi, I am Garav, and I'm playing Grango, the Toydarian gambler, who currently owns a casino on the planet of Delmara named Grango's Garrison. His life's been kind of a mess ever since he started hanging out with you guys.
I can see that.
Because he somehow just agrees on going on these wild capers that... get him almost killed, but then also just rich enough to make it worthwhile. And that's what happened last time.
You got almost killed real hard, didn't
Very
you?
Very
real almost killed, a lot.
Yeah, you keep getting your ass.
Didn't you lose a foot?
I lost a wing.
A wing.
I definitely lost a wing, which I replaced with all the money I had.
Yeah. And I'm going to be curious to learn about that. What that
so
so like.
You broke even.
Sure.
He's more machine now than Toydarian.
Do you have to like save up to get the second wing eventually, or is it because like I feel like your organic wing is gonna get tired eventually?
It's like a prosthetic limb that looks like my old one, but you can clearly tell it's not a real wing.
Well, no, that is what I want to ask you about, and we'll get into it a little more because I think it's hard to imagine a robotic wing that can flutter like those other ones. It's easier to imagine a little propeller. It just comes up out of your back.
No, it's not. It's much easier to... Look, if they can make Luke have a fully functional flesh hand...
Yeah.
Okay, all right.
I think not have a propeller.
I guess it depends on how racist roboticists are.
How does that even work?
I don't know. You've got like a little leather cavity. Strap that you've got to strap around your chest. Yeah. It's a little...
And I have a little cap with a propeller, too.
It's the only way you can stay upright.
If it was a beanie with a chin strap, then I would be okay with it.
The technology is just not there, basically.
Okay, so that's...
Like, we really should have just put a repulsor in there. I don't know why.
That's partially...
Not everyone can put rocket boosters in their ass. I'm sorry.
That sounds like someone who's not committed enough to the task.
Yeah, that's true. I don't know. Gippy would be in
it. Gippy has already done it, obviously.
just to check it out. Oh, man. Okay, so that's Grango in a nutshell.
Mm-hmm.
Right, Drew?
Hmm?
No, okay.
I wasn't going to do it that time.
Well, what? Oh, I see. Yeah.
No, that is. And then does Grango have an obligation?
I do, yeah. I love, as you can tell, I love high risk, high reward situations.
Mm-hmm.
Well, high risk. I don't know if there's a high reward. I'm just assuming there's going to be one.
Yeah, sometimes it works out and sometimes it doesn't.
Yeah.
And when you lost your wing, it did not.
Yeah, it did not work out. And that was a pretty high risk situation too.
Oh, yes.
Actually, that was a pretty bad move I made.
Yeah, you've been kind of a gambling addict recently.
Yeah.
Okay. And then last, we have a relatively new face, but actually also the person with the most episodes under his belt out of anybody ever.
Whoa.
So
weird.
Yeah.
Hi. Hello.
Hi.
Hi. Hello.
Are you Andrew?
Yes, I am. I'm Andrew. I'm going to be playing Gippy Bindu tonight. He is a at least octogenarian Mon Cal, like Admiral Akbar, like 400-pound former diplomat. He's been with basically the rebellion the whole time. Like, he's been part of like every major event in Star Wars. I think that he literally was like on the Death Star and launched Luke Skywalker out of an airlock. I don't know. There's a lot of alternate that universe happened. Weird stuff yeah. that's happened with Gibby Bindu.
In one of the podcasts, you actually blew up the Death Star.
Yeah, that's true. Yes. So anyway,
was
yeah.
Wasn't Pete Idle with you at that?
I believe so. I believe so. I would yes. not deign to remember a droid, though. So I'm sure he won't recognize.
Not
you.
Even a droid that blew up Darth Vader.
Yeah. And whatever. I mean, you're yeah. just a tool.
Those were Elseworlds that happened. Yeah. yeah.
I shot him right in the chest.
No, that's not true. You shot off his robotic limbs.
Yeah, I shot him so hard in the chest, his arms fell off.
Canonically, I believe Gippy has died of massive heart failure. But he's mysteriously back tonight, and let's
yeah,
try and
I think
figure
last
out.
Time we left you on an exploding planet.
Yeah. Yeah.
Really?
The pit, yeah.
Yeah,
that
okay.
pit.
Yeah,
that planet blew up.
Yeah.
That facility
the facility may have exploded, and you may have, at that moment, last we saw you were in the lowest levels, deep beneath the ocean of magma it was embedded in, and then that, I believe that level was also being flooded with toxic gas, as these guys were
But little do they know, those are two things I find highly erotic.
Well, so save that comment, because it was also, I believe, being flooded with raw sewage.
So basically my natural element. Yeah. So I've returned from my amazing time at the magma sewage gas spa. And now I'm here halfway across the galaxy. I think...
like a year or two later.
Yes,
basically.
Exactly. So Gippy's back. We'll figure out together why.
How that could possibly be.
But yes.
But Gippy's back. That's the takeaway.
Good to see you all again.
Good to see you guys too, yeah.
Anybody want an elf lady?
An elf lady? Are you trading your Arwen?
She looks too much like her dad.
That's the oh, then I'm into
the
it.
Like, that's the one that lights up. Is that the one that lights
that's
up?
The only one
that is it the only one that lights up?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
You've traded away your
well,
legacy.
No, hey, listen. There you go.
Give me those Tyler lips.
Yep, we still need batteries for those. So if you guys would like to see... If you'd like to see all of our goblets light up, you guys can donate to the stream. And we can buy enough batteries to operate these goblets. So you guys can always do...
That's much better.
I'm getting... Oh, oops. I need to turn this on lower in the future, right?
Lower right.
Beep, boop, beep.
Lower right.
Okay. Lower right.
Scroll up. Sorry, Google Drive.
Fascinating.
Great. So, we have some donations, it looks like.
What already?
Gonna boot in a second and tell me all about
what?
Them.
Perfect.
But yeah, if you guys what? Are new, or if you've just been lurking and you've never donated, it's really easy to do. You can donate through our twitch.tv setup. Give us some donations, either in form of XP, which you earn by watching, or in real money, which, I don't know, is maybe better, right? That could do things like influence the rolls that we're doing here. It can buy us re-rolls. Which I'll remind all of you guys, if we spend a re-roll, we go re-roll.
Was that Ken?
Simultaneous.
I thought we were doing a new one each time, but I'm fine.
Yeah,
no, we'll do that each time.
Okay.
We simultaneously do that.
I'll try to keep up.
Okay. Yeah, watch us at the changes.
All right,
can
okay,
keep it up.
Cool. Yeah.
Bloop, bloop, bloop. You can also, so yeah, donate to do that. If you want to support us regularly, you guys can join our Patreon. We have a Patreon, the Saving Throw Patreon. I think, would that be patreon.com/... Saving Throw Show. Okay, so go to there. You can donate like $1 a month. That's like $12 a year. And if you do it, If one person does it tonight, I will buy the batteries to put into these goblets.
Oh, shit, yeah.
I know.
What?
$12 a year, it's very little
turns to you. These batteries are only available on eBay. They're $400 a
battery.
Limited edition Lord of the Rings, the Fellowship of the Ring batteries.
You have to buy the original batteries.
There's just one guy in China, and he has to put the electrons in by hand.
All the electrons by hand?
He has to hand-carve Liv Tyler in every single battery.
They're powered by the rings from that movie, the actual rings are in here.
Mm. Yeah, you actually have to have the rings. Right, so that's the Patreon. You can also support us if you guys love Loot Crate. Gosh, who wouldn't love Loot Crate?
Loot Crate?
Remember Loot Crate? Mm-hmm. We are also
Loot Crate, that service that gives you a big old awesome bag of goodies every month.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, of swag.
That's the one.
That's right, of cool, of nerd swag, right?
Nerd swag?
Yeah.
Like those soulless little pop figures.
Pop vinyls, yeah.
Yeah, those things, I love them because I have a shelf of them and then I forget they're there. And so I just look over and there's just like a bunch of dead-eyed children staring out of the dark at me. Then I turn on a light and I was like, oh, it's Breaking Bad.
It's true. The one thing, though, that I feel bad for is the one licensed property that doesn't have a Funko Pop. Like, what did they do wrong? Yeah.
That does not exist.
Like, I literally have a Voltan from fucking Flash Gordon, like, Funko Pop. Like, what did you do wrong to not get one of yourself?
I think, like, daytime TV has Funko Pops. Like, yeah. Like, General Hospital Pops.
I'm pretty sure we have some. Like, they're saving for ones already.
Yeah,
what?
We're in Pop.
When I was working at SourceFed, a Funko Pop employee mailed us custom...
Yeah.
Funkos that they had
These
just
must
made
be
in
the
their off
easiest
times.
Things in the world to make.
It was pretty cool, but they all looked like they actually looked like our hosts, and I was like, "That's creepy."
Oh yeah, I was imagining they sent ones to you, like the editor.
Oh
like,
yeah,
with gosh. Like a photo, be like, "We know what you look
it
like."
It was always terrifying when someone sent the editor gifts because, like, you're not supposed to know that we are there.
This is what you look like as a dead-eyed child.
I was like, "You're right."
And if you guys want some dead-eyed child for putting in your house and spooking you out. Get Loot Crate.
Yeah.
So we're a Loot Crate influencer, which means if you go to lootcrate.com/savingthrowshow. No.
Just saving throw.
No show.
That
just
one's
saving
just
throw.
Saving throw. Yeah. So if you go to lootcrate.com/savingthrow and like get a subscription or get a subscription for somebody else for like Valentine's Day because you're dating a cool nerd or whatever, and like you really want to like blow them away.
You wish.
Yeah, the small Venn diagram of people who are dating super cool nerds and watching this show.
You've reached all none of our viewers.
That's not true. If there's anybody who's
well now,
if there's anybody
this
in
is
Venn
wishful
diagram.
Thinking for David right now. Again, rehearsed in front of a mirror. Anyway, continue.
Yes, okay, so the point I'm laboring to make at this point is that if you get a subscription, it looks really good for us. We get like a small percentage of that profit, but it also like sets us up for more great things in the future. And it means we're going to do more great fun stuff and keep you entertained. Mm-hmm. I don't know. So it seems like that's worth supporting.
I still use my recalled Infinity Gauntlet oven mitt.
I actually have that as well.
Yeah,
and
I'm living
deeply
really dangerously.
Enjoy it. So please do what they're saying.
The products are so good, even when they're like, "Please don't use this; it might melt your hand."
You might
you're
die.
Like, no,
like
it's fine.
You get Loot Crate, and first you're like, "I know what I like," and then like you get shit, and you're like, "I didn't know this existed." Thank you. Like, so.
So, guys, actually, Dom, do I need to be in the docks? Is that where I'm at to view things?
Yeah.
Okay, and just like a blank one. Cool.
There should be Steam community.
Yeah.
Mm. Ooh, that sounds fancy.
Steam.
Stream.
Oh, that's less fancy.
Cool. I will figure that out.
Initiate communication streaming protocols.
Well, how'd you get here so fast?
There's no tripod there anymore. I can go anywhere I want.
It's amazing. Yeah.
I'm going to do this, and then I'm going to do the thing that I'm waiting to do, which I can't do.
I am making a terrible error.
Oh, at the bottom.
And sending a link to this right now to the girl I'm sitting with.
Yay!
Cool!
What?
Good.
What?
Yay! Yeah.
Just one of them.
What's what province in Canada
Jamie?
Is she in?
Should have told me that.
She's over in Mar Vista, Singapore.
Should have told me her name. Because now I'm going to use it.
It's all right. You don't know the other two girls I'm seeing's names.
Oh!
I find that this explains a lot of the table absorption in David's singlehood.
What?
Yeah, I'm also seeing three different people, David.
I'm seeing nobody.
How alone are you right now?
Taking all the women. Give them to me.
I mean,
more sexy men.
Just deliver all the drugs.
I'm sorry.
How much do you pay for health insurance?
Because as much, like, way more than you pay for Loot Crate. That's all I'm saying.
If you can afford health insurance,
get rid of your health insurance. Get 50 Loot Crate. Honestly, like, you might die of tomorrow. Might as well be happy today. Loot Crate.
Yeah.
Loot Crate.
Yeah.
Right. Loot Crate.
Loot Crate. There's no future.
Loot Crate, where it's GERD. The nerd.
Oh boy.
It came back.
Not this again.
Oh boy. Oh.
Guys, I literally can't look at you while you're saying it.
Sadness is palpable.
And with that note.
Yeah, that actually gave me heartburn.
No, this is important. That needs to be a gift.
Okay.
Yeah, do it, chat.
And with that note, guys, I am going to part the blast doors of reality. Space. Black starfield. Stars speckled throughout it.
It's my next character's name.
Black Starfield?
Yeah.
That's a pretty good name. And then imagine, if we will, a void. Like, if you had not nothingness, but like nothingness in movement. Like India ink filling a vast pool. And somewhere down below, a plug has been taken out, and it's swirling down. It's swirling down, down and down, forming this perfect whirlpool of darkness that's spiraling inwards. And we're staring into it, and you almost feel yourself as you're looking at it. You almost feel yourself getting pulled into that, into the center of it. And you hear that like pulsation of the sound of the darkness swirling in, or almost like a reverse pulsation. Like it's not pulsing out, but it's pulling you inwards more and more. And it seems to be saying, you can almost hear a voice in it, a voice in the abyss, saying something to you, promising you something in the very, very heart, just beyond the other side of that darkness. If you just plunge in and get to the bottom, that there is something there. Who is having that dream? Someone wakes up. Gippy Bindu. You're in the middle of a bustling casino.
I've never excreted so many feelings. What on earth? Something. Perhaps I've got one last adventure in me.
Middle-aged woman who was sitting next to you gets up, leaving little strands of sticky fluid, and just
I'm
walks
sorry,
away.
You'll want to visit the nearest clinic, I assure you.
Walks away, we follow her in a nice sweeping pan as her face starts to turn green and pale. Through the bustling, prosperous halls of Grango's own casino on the forested distant planet of Delmara, a tiny little blue-green gem floating out there on the edges of the Centrality, which is this extreme northern space. It's called the Centrality kind of ironically because it's essentially just an empty void just populated with a few planets. But land is cheap. Mm-hmm. And sure enough, you guys are set up there with Grango's Garrison on the outskirts of Port Delmara, the only civilization in this whole planet, which is otherwise overrun with rings.
Listen, we got to make this casino real weird. We're going to attract business.
Well, it's actually, you kind of have, and you kind of are attracting a bunch of business.
I hear there's lots of weird stuff going on here.
So what do we do with our...
Sign me up.
Our upgrades.
That's a great question. Are you talking about the financial windfall that you guys
have?
Yes,
both personally and as a collective.
Well, that's a great question. So we kind of, as we drift through and our panning continues to the casino, filing one patron after another, we can see the casino is hopping. We've got tons of people in. It's a beautiful day outside, bright blue sky. I guess you have windows in your casino, which is always a bad move. But, you know, you guys are, what, just a couple floors?
They're covered with ads, so you can't really tell.
This is amazing. It's like a P.T. Anderson, like, Boogie Nights, like, one-er. Like, you were just, like, going through the casino. Oh, my God.
It's an incredible shot. It's amazing. Yeah. But, yeah, we're following people as they go back and forth, and there's people at the space slot machines. There's people playing space pachinko and space craps. Yeah, and what's the other favorite thing? Non-space Keno? They just have regular Keno still?
Regular Keno.
Yeah,
regular
space Baccarat, which actually makes more sense than regular Baccarat.
Yeah. And so it's going
very
on.
Easy to learn.
Floor boss,
so is your mom.
Doobie Scoo.
Yeah, Doobie Scoo.
Right, Doobie Scoo.
Going around in his, what would be like a red vest or something like that.
Do you guys know what Scooby-Doo's real name is?
What?
He's a dog.
Scooby-Doo's his nickname. He's got a proper name.
No. You're thinking of Shaggy.
The Avatar of Death?
Scoobert Doobert?
It's Scoobert Doobert.
Why did I instantly know that?
I don't know, but isn't it the best name ever?
Yeah, pretty much.
So like, if he's in trouble, Scoobert Doobert.
Like, man.
Did you shit in the van?
Scoobert Doobert is his father, man.
That's a really good Shaggy.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
That's coming back.
Yeah,
he just wrote
putting that. Yeah, that's on the board.
Next character. All right.
one of Gippy's many illegitimate offspring.
Doobie Scoo. Was he a human? What was his
name? No, he was a Duros.
Have calamari.
A Duros. Okay. Yeah. He's going through, looking like real. He's got like I don't know, some space data pad. I don't have to keep saying space. He's got a data pad. As he's going through, and like some of like the different people are coming up to him, be like, "We need more chips over here," and like this and that. And the stage show's going on. He's making his way through the crowd. Has anybody seen Rango? Says in his best Scooby-Doo voice. And he catches the voice of P9L, who is apparently just speaking to Gringo over there, asking, "What are we doing with this windfall? This financial windfall?" He comes in, so we push in on where the two of you are meeting, probably.
Raggy! Raggy!
I think we should put it into the casino, but if we put it into the town, we get more people in the town, and then more people to the casino.
And if we put it into the ship, it makes it easier for us to get out, get more money, bring it back here.
I don't plan on leaving ever again.
That's right.
That's a good point. Well, honestly, if we put the money in the casino, the town will grow.
That's right.
Because the casino grows.
The ship, as we put it over there, the old Badu class Spectre, known as the Hertz, formerly owned by none other than Merslek himself, a Imperial lieutenant, now deceased, former secret husband of Tamaya Lek.
Secret husband.
Deeply disappointed this is not the Doobie 5, but okay, whatever.
Jeanette wasn't around when they named
it. That's some deep cut for you fans out there. Anyway.
Oh, this is named the Hertz because...
Oh, yeah.
General, it was originally Mercer's father's ship.
Yeah, his name, and so...
General E. Lek.
Mercer's name is Lek, and yeah, it was General
Lek Trick.
Lek. And then Trick was supposed to, is implied to be in the end. So the Hertz... No, I'm going to stop explaining.
I'll catch up on this later to prevent dead air.
He was hyphenated, General Electric.
Yeah. Wait, let's ignore that. So anyway, the Hertz, which is sitting...
It's electricity jokes, kids.
In your... I guess there's just a huge amount of ground since this planet is mostly uninhabited. So the Hertz is sitting somewhere in some one of your massive covered hangars. Uh-huh. One of the finest spaceships ever built. It's actually hand-built. Every Badu-class luxury yacht is individually hand-built by one essentially one family that is in charge.
Mostly children. Not because they're better workers or that their hands are smaller, but just because it makes them sadder.
Well, that remains to be seen. But it is a phenomenal ship. Now, when you guys inherited it, it was beaten up and formerly used by space pirates. So that's one of the things you might consider spending your current financial windfall on. The other thing, as you pointed out, was maybe improving the town of Port Del Mara, which is, suffered a massive Rancor attack less than a year ago and is still limping its way back.
But it was fabulous television.
But what if we turn it into a park where people can come and see the Rancors behind enclosed cages? And, you know, it's safe, and there's a car that travels through.
And the possibility of a failure resulting in violence is incredible. That was a yes.
Utter nonsense. Would never happen.
Sure. No, of course not. Never.
It
would be impossible.
A Rancor passes.
I have a great feeling about this.
Rancor passes in front of the camera. Fortunately, we pull out to get a little focus on it, and it's not actually the full-sized Rancor. It is the baby Rancor. That's right. Owned by none other than Riggles, who would probably be bringing this Rancor by.
Can you even own a Rancor?
Can you own a rainbow?
You can love it.
Technically, yes. I do. Yeah. I have this receipt right here.
Yes, paperwork.
Because I'm not a penniless hippie.
So, Root, you are heading by on your way probably to a stage show. Is it time for your stage show?
Is it time for my stage show?
Isn't it always time for you and your stage show?
Listen,
Root and Yerp don't follow the timetables that anyone sets. When we decide it's time for a show, it's time for a show.
It's time for a show!
Oh, then it's time for a show.
The murmur starts to go around to the people assembled. Oh, it's just Root. She's getting this another Rangor show. Yeah, it's electric throughout the crowd. I mean, also, people are probably terrified as they see an actual 6.5 foot tall stop motion Rangor moving through this casino as it comes forward with Root moving along. You know, and then when we cut to you, there's just a big foam leg that keeps moving right next to your head. Yeah, and then we cut out, and then it's you and stop motion Rangor. And yeah, it's great.
Really, really high tech CGI-ish.
Do you have a vote that you would cast in terms of where this financial windfall would be going? In terms of improving the Hertz, which is currently filled with a biome of plants, which you've been filling it with, and a hydroponic system.
My hydroponics are on that ship.
You do have
but
that.
But I've also like built myself a hut here.
I think we should put it into the casino.
Not the town?
I think we should put it in the casino, and then the casino can commit a certain portion of proceeds to improving the town, which then also becomes great because it's a tax write-off. And then when you inevitably run for office of this town and become the governor of the planet, as well as a casino owner, you not only have you made a huge windfall for yourself again, but you've put in a lot of goodwill with the people of the town.
As long as I can win it all in Sabacc to the point where you guys want to murder me, that's fine.
Says this...
Who is that?
Voice as you come staggering into the conversation, or maybe not staggering, sedately, stately...
Does he walk?
...strolling your way.
I thought you still have a hover sled to get around.
No, there's no hover sled. There's just like
Baron Harkonnen without the moral compass.
No, there's just droids that have been lashed to a certain like a piece of steel that just like pulling me up.
Wait, droids lashed to a piece of steel.
Yes, they're like walking. They're walking, and there's like oil like coming out of their eyes as they're walking forward.
I hear that I couldn't help but somehow overhearing that you were looking for financial advice.
So are you prone on this piece of metal, or are you standing up on it?
No, I'm prone. Like, I'm probably looking at the ceiling. But looking, the cataracts are so thick you can't tell.
You probably grabbed a chaise lounge from the foyer.
That makes a little more sense. There was a piece of furniture that you Shanghai, you were using your immense leadership and charisma.
Exactly.
Shanghai two droids.
I demanded it. If they were going to kick me out, I demanded it as recompense for my slights.
So how about this then? So it's a chaise lounge that was in the lobby, and then the two droids are just like, have the... one on each leg, and they're just backwards, just dragging it through the casino.
Whatever causes them distress.
That causes
that makes the most terrible dragging noise.
It's extremely slow going. And I'm going to give you just 2 strain off the top, just for breathing in gravity.
Right. God, I've had days like that.
So yeah, he comes in to this conversation. So we've got a vote for the casino, a vote for the ship, a vote for the town. Now, there would be a deciding vote normally, and that would be from your erstwhile fourth member, Tamiya. Tamiya Jones, nay Leck, right, of Secret Husband fame.
Yep.
She has been missing low these last few months, off on her whatever own weird odyssey. The last time you guys saw her was also the last time you saw your erstwhile mentor, the now deceased General Jan Dodonna.
What?
Yep. Formerly the leader of the... New Republic and the Resistance's entire armada kind of became your guys' mentor and then died, saving you from a planet filled with treasure.
Mm-hmm. Mentor seems like a strong word.
I suppose you're wondering how I got through security detail. I noticed that you hired humans. Unfortunately, the smell I excrete at this point in my mating cycle is toxic to them. So I'm sorry about that. I'm sure you'll find more of those humans to breed like rabbits anyway.
Are you dying right now? What's happening to you?
No, I assure you that is a virile smell and not the smell of a decaying corpse.
Now, technically, medically speaking, he's dying of about 7 different things at once, but they all just happen to cancel each other out.
Burns effect!
Was he ever cured of one disease? He would instantly die of 6 others.
Your medical slave is quite astute.
As you guys are continuing to bicker, Root and Rancor, Root and
Yerp.
Ranky Walk? Yes. Root and Yerp have reached the stage. Someone was already on it, but they are quickly vacating it.
Yeah.
As they see you coming, like getting the band together.
Well, the Rancor always eats the act before. They eat the opening act.
Kind of part of
the slow ones. There's the there's like the little like droopy McCool guy with like a space tuba on trying to get out of the way.
That's why you just hire like the worst dancers like by the boatload.
Yeah. A lot of the Twi'leks who didn't make the cut to get onto.
Like, oh, so you have 2 years of jazz tap. What would you say your total protein count is?
How many kilograms of meat are you?
Yeah.
Because very dietary standards.
I don't write the questions. They're just on this form.
Otherwise, it's very difficult to keep this thing fed.
Yeah.
Skrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrr So this big, probably it's got the standard red curtains and it's a big black reinforced stage that's a little bit raised up in front of the whole showroom floor, which is pretty much open to gaming. Everyone has gone quiet and is looking up at you guys. You three in the corner who are just chatting notice the silence and...
Oh, well, obviously, Root goes to... Root's getting really good at this. She's got a good MC patter going on, so she goes up to the front and goes, "Oh, good, thank you for coming out today, everybody. Be sure to tip your servers."
A little point over to him, okay. Yeah.
And Yerp is like lumbering around, like, "I'm gonna have a great show, buddy. This first trick, I call it the Diamond." That's the name. The Diamond.
Okay. Silence continues to greet you. You quit talking. Just dead silence as everyone is staring up at you on stage.
Yeah.
Give me a survival roll. Let's see how good your check is. Survival being the best skill, I think, to use.
Yeah, yeah.
How many yellows am I giving here?
I think I have.
Should we establish
two yellows, destiny two points?
After this.
All right.
Let's do it before this. Okay, well, let me tell you the difficulty. On a scale of easy, medium, or hard, how hard is it to do the diamond?
The diamond is—it's the beginning of the act. This isn't one of this okay. is sort of a warm up. It's a medium. You want to start with something pretty good. Go to some of your lesser stuff. End on your biggest thing.
It's a medium, so I'll just make it. A red.
I don't want my closer. It gives me nowhere to go.
Okay, so before you roll that up, I think that is a good suggestion. Let's see if we want any points in our destiny pool. So we're going to roll our force die. That's going to determine how many light side and dark side points we have to kind of fudge rolls as the game goes through. These guys use light side points to turn their weak little green dice into powerful yellow dice. I use dark side points to turn my bad purple dice into really bad red dice.
However little sense that makes given the actual actions we take.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, try and justify it. Drew, go ahead and start rolling this force die up and tell me what you got.
Well, that's two dark side points.
Yeah, go put two dark side points over there somewhere. Where
thanks, Drew. Track.
You're welcome.
One light side point.
Yeah! Light side point. Go ahead and add that to the pile.
I only got one.
I threw poorly.
One dark side.
There you go, sir.
Normally, I'm really good at...
I'll take that.
Rolling light side points.
Should be one light side.
I rolled a dark side. And Mr. Andrew.
Shit, what do we got? We got one dark side. Ooh. Sorry, guys.
Unbelievable.
Go ahead, throw that.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
Oh, shut it. Or whatever they say in that new movie. Spoiler warning.
Oh, that's right. Let me throw that out really quick, guys. Spoiler warning, or potential spoiler warning for Rogue One. I cannot guarantee we're not going to make references to Rogue One. Probably as jokes that may spoil things. So if you haven't seen it, if you're saving it, just be aware that we may make jokes or something. So
yeah, spoiler warning, they blow up the Death Star. as a result of things that happen.
Yeah.
Yeah, not in that movie, but in a different movie. Spoiler warning. Okay.
Spoiler warning, Forrest Whitaker's fucking weird.
What are you talking about?
He was like one of my characters. Wait a minute, though. Bend over here. Talene, what are you rolling?
Actually, that was like you doing Forrest Whitaker.
All right. Yeah. I'm rolling two yellows, two greens against one red and one purple.
And take a boost die because you did have good patter.
Such good patter.
Oh!
Way to start. Oh my gosh.
Kaboom!
The Bard 1971, by the way, here's our first donation
the
of the night. Gives a reroll to Talene.
Oh. Yeah. Yeah.
So that is
well deserved.
Two threat, four success, and a triumph.
I totally destroy this trick.
So describe what the diamond entails.
The diamond, what happens is that my baby Rancor first performs a headstand. I climb to the top
of the
baby Rancor onto the foot.
Just to keep the scales in mind, so it's like 6 feet tall and you're like 2 feet tall.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Once up there, the baby Rancor begins to spin me like a ball with his feet. And when I achieve maximum velocity, I launch out, spread my arms.
Uh-huh. You can say diamond?
Say diamond.
And then launch into the air?
I launch into the air out towards the crowd.
Oh.
It's crowd surfing time. Nobody expects it.
No one expects it. Oh!
Not this trick again! You broke it so many tables! So
that is technically, this is just an attack.
That's fine.
Gibby just goes, and several humans drop dead instantly as their face melts off.
Is there a visible fume that comes out of it? Just,
this is the greatest burlesque I've ever seen. The reviews did not lie. Bravo, sir, bravo.
I wave over to the pit boss. He's hand out some masks.
Passing those around. The humans are learning to stay away from him.
Start rusting.
But there's an Ithorian. There's an Ithorian nearby you who starts blushing.
Yes. You fear me, friend.
Too strained for your two threat as you hit the ground because no one catches you for the surfing. Luckily, you're fluffy. So it's more of a bounce.
Yeah.
Charmin Bear style. Up, back up to your feet, and the show continues.
Yeah.
Great. So that's going pretty well. Wild applause. Is it a triumph? Huge applause.
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
Woo! Yeah!
This is a hot audience. Walk.
Yeah, and in fact, as we pan, or we do a wide establishing shot finally of the outside of Grango's garrison, we see that it's looking much better than it was in previous years. It is no longer off strip, it is now merely off strip. Kind
Excellent.
Of Fremont Street yes. style.
We move it every year. We just take the building.
It's actually easier just to move the rest of the town.
Yeah, probably.
Well, and there's the giant sign with all the neon light bulbs flashing around the outside mm-hmm. of it and everything like that, mm-hmm. that is proudly displaying that Root and Europe in Rank Ewok. You know,
Rank Ewok. And it's got really great pictures with like good lighting and makeup done, hair and makeup on the Ewok.
They'll just see makeup on fur.
I got a special little granny babushka that's all sequins.
Oh wow! So yeah, and this is the source of your.
Do you ever wear any clothes like non-traditional Ewok clothes?
Well, just the sometimes quote. I wear a jacket.
Other quotes just like I will probably eat you. That's exclamation point!
Get back here! I'm going to eat you. So yeah, this is the source of your guys' unexpected windfall.
Oh my gosh!
Is Roots Ewok. In Rancor Act, which he has taken on the road to several major locations, including Granga's Gambles. God, why did I do this to myself? Nearby Hut Run Casino. You guys showed off there. You guys showed off at some other locations. It's drawing a lot of attention.
Have we not blown up Granga's yet?
No, nearby.
I feel like we keep overlooking that.
Well, they're way bigger than you and way more well-funded.
Yeah, but we've blown up planets, David.
It's an orbital space platform, and it's also run by the Huts. So
hey, you know.
Hey, you tell me what you guys are doing.
Shouldn't they call my
about
style
destroying an
terrorism.
Orbital space platform is that orbits decay.
Well, I will say that it's some of the reason that you're also popular is partially for the act, maybe a little more so for the famed gladiator accomplishments. Mm-hmm. Ever since you single-handedly murdered Woo the Wookiee.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. In that pit fight, that is so your fame has spread and it has brought people. It's a great gimmick, has brought tons of people into Gringo's garrison.
Okay.
And,
okay.
And then your natural business acumen has capitalized upon that, so things are Excellent. Going pretty well.
Excellent. Let's let her leave.
But after the show, Root feels like she's lost something, mm-hmm. settling into this life, accepting fame.
That's a good question.
Now we're just like reenacting the woo-woo battle all the time, and we can't even get real Chewbacca's.
Not even real Chewbacca.
That's weirdly racist, kind of, sort of. Not really.
Well,
we can't get real Wookiees to do it. So it's just like
you mean to murder and eat?
I'll get it.
It's always Doobie Scoo dressed up as a Wookiee.
It's just Doobie Scoo wearing a rug. Like a fuzzy rug.
Because I freaking hate him.
Thank you. You freaking hate that?
I freaking hate him.
Thank you.
Frelling?
Mm-hmm. Okay, so.
It seems your Ewok friend is no longer enjoying murder lust. I feel like the real killings on stage would be the way to go. We enjoyed that quite a bit on Dak. It was something that we would do all the time on our giant cruise ships.
I've pitched that idea several times.
Mm-hmm. I'm not against it. It's this damn regulation by the rebellion, you know. They gave me the land, and they
just use humans. No one cares about them.
No, they're mainly humans on there, so they're kind of, itsy bitsy about it.
There goes the neighborhood.
Yeah. But maybe.
That is true, yeah. There's a lot of rebel regulations, and you guys get regular communiques and everything like that from them, especially given that you guys have position within the Rebel Alliance as kind of extrajudicial investigators.
But if I own the town, that means I make the rules. And I get a statue, too. I was promised a statue. That's going to happen.
But at this point, we should address, are you flying as you're speaking to these guys? Are you hovering?
Yeah, I am. I've replaced my wing with some surgery.
Your wing, which was sliced off of your body.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. By what's his name?
Former Moth Vulganus.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Citizen Vulganus.
Ex Moth Vulganus.
That's right. Ex Moth Vulganus.
Sliced off my wing.
Also one of the richest men in the galaxy. Currently dead at the bottom of
the
pile of
rubble. The deadest man in the galaxy.
Yes. So you have a replacement wing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's hear a little bit about this. How do you have a replacement wing?
Obviously, it was the rebellion that helped me do this, because there ain't nobody in Delmara that's going to do surgery on me. So I got to go to one of the rebel bases, and they gave me this prosthetic, very lightweight alloy wing. It's translucent, semi-translucent, like my other wing, but you can clearly tell that it's not a natural wing.
Okay.
It's curved at the top, and like it's got like a hex pattern going on in the wings, so you can tell where that translucence is happening.
That's cool. Does the do the strut parts match your skin tone, or do they look really artificial?
They match the look of it, but not the color.
Okay.
So it's definitely discolored from what it should look like.
So for Tuadarians, is this like a sexy like scar and eye patch like kind of situation, or is it like, oh god, what happened to you?
No, it's pretty, I paid pretty good money for it.
Okay.
But it still looks like one of those weird skin eye patch like colors. Like, you know when like Ty had in the later seasons of Battlestar Galactica.
Well, I can't quit you, Bill.
Yeah.
It is solar powered though.
It's a solar powered wing.
Yeah,
great.
So I need to get some sunlight every couple days.
You don't have to pop in and out fusion batteries all the time.
No. Yeah, because I opted out for that because I don't want a battery stuck to me. I want it to be
organic.
Yeah.
Okay, that makes sense.
Organic.
Okay, so you're flying around all right, and it probably occasionally can act up, for example, if you roll the despair.
Absolutely, yeah. Why not?
All right, sounds good. But it's actually grafted probably into your body and stuff, so okay, you're good as new.